welcome over here to Fonda Speedway. We are here for the first race of the NASCAR Shell Dirt Ringer Series. It's going to be a great race over here at Fonda, a little bit different different day than you were expecting. Of course, it's Tuesday today. And also want to mention that I got a guest over here who's not going to be doing co-commentating because he cannot speak. It's my dog and he's laying in the sun over here. So if you suddenly hear me scare or something, or because he's starting to bark, somebody's at the door and I'm going to lock him out of here. It's probably because my sister is coming home. She will be coming home here fairly soon, I think. But anyway, back to the race. Going to be a very interesting race. Going to be a very interesting series. Of course, the first dirt series that I've done. And I'm not even sure if there has been any other dirt series. First dirt series in NASCAR as well. So, looking forward to this. I will take you now through everybody on the grid. So, if you don't want to see that, just move away. So, we got over here. The pole sitter is John Cittadino, number one car. Of course, we all know him. He's been in NASCAR now for quite some seasons. Joshua Michelson is outside, the Phillips Truck Series president. NASCAR Phillips Truck Series president. Then we got over here Hayden Klein in number 13 car. Back over here. And Stephen Kimball returning to NASCAR. He said that he really liked the series, so I'm very pleased to hear that. Looking forward to having him in this series as well. Then we got Joseph Onesto over here in his own painted car. Really great looking car. So the 062 it is. You can see a little zero on top of that car. And on his outside is Jake Williams in the 08 car, which actually has no number at all on it. But, well, it's this car is called the 08 car, so okay. Jake Williams also making his return to a series over here of mine. Then we got Bas Nice, teammate of Joseph Nessa, right behind him in the 061 car. Anna Gregg in the number 18 car is on her outside. So two women starting side by side. Then we got Paul Winners in the number 75 car. And this is something surprising. What I did, Joanna Darcy was supposed to be in a 36 racing in this series. A couple of friends of Paul Winners signed up for this series. So what I did, I just changed them around. So Paul Winners was supposed to be racing in the Starbucks Super Speedway series. He will be racing in this series. And Joanna Darcy will be racing in the Starbucks Super Speedway series. So Paul Winners, one of four people who are not only doing this competition, but they have competition between each other. And to the other three, I will come later. Then we got Aileen Sout in the number 51 car. Also, well, she has been in every single series I've done, I think. She also is now in the TomTom International Touring Series. Still spots open if you are curious. Joseph Nessa just has done the sign-up or the shootout of that really great series. And actually, Aileen Sout won that shootout. So that was really, really happy. Really happy with that she was. So here we got Kevin Waters. Yes, indeed, I'm correct. He's the sibling of Natalie Waters. And Natalie Waters will be racing in the Phillips Cup Series Season 6. New faces to the sport. And we got Bertus Fred in the 88. And that is also a new name. He is one of those four people, just like Paul Winners, who is holding competition between each other. All good friends. Then we got over here the 24 car of Nicole Tronowicz. Of course, the Polish girl. Signed up by Anna Gregg. She will be back in the series. She still hasn't raced in the Phillips Cup Series, but, well, Phillips Cup Series, of course, the most popular series, and I think the biggest series of mine. Of course, that is where everything started with in NASCAR. Now there are like 8 or 9 other series, so I'm really pleased with that. Those other series are just as great. Then we got the 22 car, another new name to the sport. It is Kyle Thomas, and we're looking forward to having him in NASCAR. Then we got the 72 car of Michael Krakander, and he is also one of those people together with Paul Winners and Bertus Fred. So third person of that. Excuse me. Now we got the 43 car of Zachary Robinson back in number 43 car. I've said that now. Of course, Andrew Robinson drove the number 43 in the Starbucks Super Speedway Series, and now it is Zachary Robinson driving the 43 car. Then we got over here Christine Emerson, and actually the two Emersons are standing right next to each other. Of course, Christine Emerson, you probably know her as Christine Rangay in the Starbucks Super Speedway Series. She took the name of her sister-in-law, if I'm correct. Of course, sister-in-law is Jamie Emerson, and she's starting right on her outside. Then we got over here Judith Piette in the number 89 car, back in the series, and she's going to be in every, I think, pretty much every series. She is going to be in the Phillips Cup series, the Starbucks Super Speedway series, of course, the Shell Dirtringer series. Also is now in the TomTom International Touring series, and of course, the Phillips Nationwide series, Jane Pinter's series, which just had the Daytona 500 yesterday, I think, or the day before that. Oops, wrong way. Then we got Sean Howe in number 38 car, and Joseph Nesto made a car for him. So thank you very much, Joseph Nesto, for making a car. I said that nobody was going to make a car or customs, and well, I'm not going to do it. I'm very busy now. Of course, I'm doing this race quickly in the spare time I have left. Then we got Judith's teammate, Jocelyn van der Aert. You can see pretty much the same car, except for the weird thing is these are two different types of modified cars. But Jocelyn van der Aert, teammate of Judith Piette, over here in number 98 car. Then we got Blake Houshield in number 35 car, back in the series. Keith Batson in number 37 car. He has been in every single race of mine. Seriously, every single race. So I'm glad that after 1 year he's still over here, and he said that he fully supports the Phillips Cup Series, Starbucks Super Speedway Series, and all the other Descar Series. So I'm really pleased with that. Thank you very much, Keith Batson. Outside of him is Jane Pinter, of course, number 10 car, Phillips Nationwide Series president. Great series, that is. And then we got number 5 car is for Harry Hills. And I put on my paper Harry Hill, but I'm pretty sure it's Harry Hills. Of course, he is then... I'm now kind of confused. I think it was Natalie Hills, and it was Kelly Waters and Natalie Hills, which have siblings over here of Kevin Waters and Harry Hills. That's how it's going to be, man. I'm kind of mixing up those people. Of course, all four are new to the sport. And we got Sam Brady in number 3 car on his outside, looking to see what he can do in the number 3 car. Then we got Dirk Roogkloot, the fourth person. And the fun thing is, you could see up there it says Die Roogkloot or Droogkloot. And, well, if you're Dutch, you know what that means. It's funny. Then we got number 2 car of Dom Caps, starting all the way in the back. Well, not all the way, because, of course, Inge Lambeliana is starting right behind him. And the 00 car, not the 01 car, but 00 car. And we got the 87 car of Connor Breen, and we welcome Connor Breen back to Dascar. He has been out for a while now because of all the crap he has gotten over him because of, I'm not sure, it was stealing videos or something, but he is back and we're glad to have him back again. Of course, he's welcome. And finally, we got the 0 car of Jared Stymest, starting all the way in the back. So we go up front over here. A couple of things about this racetrack. Almost pressed the wrong button over there again. A couple of things about this racetrack to mention. Pit road is kind of weird. It's a little bit laggy in the beginning, but I think that it's going to be better. And, well, you get used to it. I just did a test race, and, well, I got used to it fairly quickly. Pit road is going to be an issue because when cars get on pit road, a lot of times they can't get out of it. And that is just very weird. You can see them moving a little loud, but... Ladies and gentlemen, we're going green flag racing over here for the first Dirtringer Series race ever. And with a bad camera view, I will just keep it like this. We're going to see a lot of interesting racing over here. You can see them storming into turn number one is John Cittadino in the lead. Hayden Klein slides in behind him. There are the two TND cars. And what you're going to see, people getting loose. Out of nowhere, sliding into the wall on the entries of turn number one and turn number three. That's what you're going to see. Oh, contact behind her. Contact is most of the times not a very big problem, but it could sometimes be. Stephen Kimball got into Joshua Michaels over there. Joshua Michaels falling back. And he called Trnovich on his inside over here. As we got close racing, people, all different lines. Man, this dirt racing is really different from just the ordinary, of course, asphalt racing. And it's fun. I have three series and they're all completely different. Of course, we got just normal Phillips Cup series, which is kind of like NASCAR. Then we got the Super Speedway series. Of course, it's a NASCAR mod, but the racing is completely different. Two cars into the wall, Dirk Rookloot and Jamie Emerson. And that will bring out the caution. Though I'm not sure if these guys are already under caution. Well, these guys are. They're leading. That group is the 061 car. Bassanese. I will probably say a couple of times 06 or just 61. So leading is John Cittadino. And here are those guys coming back again. Jamie Emerson, Dirk Rookloot, both involved in the first caution. John Cittadino leading Hayden Klein and Joseph Nesto. They're a space car and they have to get back over to the front. So that was our first caution of the series after around 5 laps it was. So I'm going to take you to the replays of what happened over here to Dirk Rookloot and Jamie Emerson, two rookies in NASCAR. So this is what you're going to see a lot happening today. I don't know if that is good English, but this is going to happen a lot. You see Dirk Rookloot. Dirk was kind of interesting, actually. He got turned by Judith Piette over there as they all got into each other. And there he goes into the wall with Jamie Emerson, excuse me. Of course it is. Oh, man, look at that car. That's not healthy. That you're also going to see that a lot. It's a little bit getting used to everything. Things are all different. I think the helicopter view should show it really good what happened over here. There you can see Judith Piette drives in a little bit too hard, gets into Inge Lambuliana, and then Inge Lambuliana slides up into the 38 and 21 car. Sean Howell can barely save it, but Dirk Rookloot and Jamie Emerson cannot, and both go into the wall over here. So that was our first caution of the day. Ooh. Okay, quickly gone. And here we got John Cittadino. He's still in the lead, and passing over here for the lead is difficult, but it is possible. I've seen that in the test race. It is possible. So we're going to be curious what happens over here when we go to the restart. So we are back live again with John Cittadino in the lead. Second is Hayden Klein. Third is Joseph Onesto in 062 car. Fourth is Bassanese in 061 car. Fifth is Paul Winners. Sixth is Kevin Waters. Seventh is Nicole Trnovich. Eighth is Michael Krakander. Ninth is Christine Emerson. And tenth is Anna Gregg. And I just noticed that I haven't even said how this race is called. Ladies and gentlemen, race at Fonda Speedway. It's called the UNOH 280. I'm not really sure if you say it like that, but well, you'll see it in the title. Ladies and gentlemen, John Cittadino brings them to the green once again. Here we go. Coming out of turn number two, everything's still going good for the leaders. Somebody's getting passed over here. It's the 7 car of Kevin Waters, who's stuck on the high side. And when you're on the high side, you're going to get passed by a lot of people. And of course, the danger of getting in trouble is then also bigger. Well, of course, yeah. Well, it's on the inside, it's also difficult racing. We see people getting loose on the inside and then sliding to the outside. And then, well, you can imagine what happens then. Both go into the wall. And also it happens sometimes that the person who wrecks, when somebody wrecks, everybody or a few guys behind them also wreck. So well, that's something you're also going to see as we see very close racing over Hayden Klein and John Cittadino. Oh, they got into each other over there. Two leaders really going after each other, Hayden Klein and John Cittadino. Of course, I'm not really sure, but I think that John Cittadino lives close to a dirt racetrack. Maybe that has an influence on his racing skills. Of course, Utica Rome. Oh, contact behind in the back over here. Christine Emerson and Michael Krakander. And seems like Michael Krakander is going to lose a spot to Christine Emerson over here. And also Anna Gregg is now going underneath the 72 car. And I'm not even sure if I should say car or if I should say mod. But I'm just going to say car because I'm used to that. 22, Kyle Thomas in the rookie. Oh, contact there. Judith Piet got turned by Aileen de Zuid almost. No, that's Nicole Tronovich. Oh, and she goes into the wall. And there you can see it. Multiple people go into the wall. Oh, and ooh, more contact. Zachary Robinson involved. We saw Keith Batson, that is, I think. Dirk Roogkloot may be involved in it. Judith Piet was involved. And Joslyn van Aert. Both teammates were involved. John Cedina is still in the lead. And I think that nothing else happened over here. Somebody is on pit road. There, Bertus Fred in the rear of the field. And we're kind of stacking things up over here. So there, Jamie Emerson is on pit road. And that's one thing you're going to see a lot. So, first, pretty big crash over here. Turn one, we're going to take a look what happened over here. And, well, we're going to see how big the damage is for a few people. As Michael Krakander, I think he had something happen. We'll take a look at that too. So, John Cedina in lead. Let's take you to the replays. Well, this actually started on the exit of turn number four. It's Nicole Tranovich who got turned by the 51 car of Aileen de Zuid a little bit. There you can see she may have gone into the 9 car also, but... And there they slide, and it seems like Aileen de Zuid can save it, but Nicole Tranovich cannot. And she eventually, she just loses it because 9 car of Joshua Michaels lost it. And into the wall they go. There you can see the 37 car spinning. The 89 car got into it. Bertus Fred almost got in it, but I think he is fine. Ooh, he might have gotten a little bit damaged over there. He got damaged from the 43 car, who also spun up front over there. And there, Joslyn van Aert. And, well, we're going to take a look at the others who crashed behind her. I think Dirk Roogkloot might have gone into this for the second time. Where is he? He's all the way in the rear of the field. So we're just going to look over here. That car got involved in it. There you can see. Oops. Damn. Jane Pinter also got into it. And there Dirk Roogkloot got into the wall. Almost hit Joslyn van Aert. But she was lucky. You can see they just got loose over here. Had to dodge people. And that's why they got loose. And you will see this happen more often. There Judith Piet just lost it. Got into Keith Batson, who got up of the ground a little bit. And just people spinning over here. And we should look at Michael Krakander now. I want to take a look at him for a moment. I'm not sure if anything happens over here. Oh, he got turned. Okay, I've not seen that happen yet today. But he got turned over here by Kevin Waters in the number 7 car. Just got into it. And ooh, that's a big hit into the rear. On the rear. Michael Krakander was running in 8th position. And I think he will be alright. The rear of the... Oh, Inge Lamaliana almost got into him. The rear of those cars are pretty strong. They're stronger than the front, obviously. Because the engine is up front on the front of the cars. So I think that Michael Krakander will be alright. These guys, well, making pit stops, and that is not good. When you make a pit stop, you're most likely going to get stuck on pit road. Just like over here, Jamie Emerson. We'll see now. Ladies and gentlemen, we'll take you now to the green flag. One lap from gone, green flag racing. We still got John Cedino in the lead, who has been leading ever since the start of this race. Second is Hayden Klein now. Third is the 062 of Joseph Nesta. Fourth is Beth Sinise. Fifth is Paul Winder, still the best running of the four, as two of the four got into trouble. And, well, Bertus Fred is all the way in the rear of the field. He almost got into it, but I think, well, no, he did get damaged. So sixth is Christine Emerson, seventh Anna Gregg, eighth is Michael Krakander. He is alright though. Ninth is Kevin Waters and tenth is Kyle Thomas. So let's see how this is going to play out. And I should show the standings over here. 21 cars on pit road, 37 and a 9 as well. And oh, John Cittadino is getting passed over here. Hayden Klein goes underneath him. Hayden Klein to the inside of John Cittadino. And Bas Nys goes to the inside of her teammate Joseph Ernesto. And it is Hayden Klein who takes the lead. Lead change and on lap 22. And I just noticed that my microphone is still on loud, so you might notice that, but oh well. John Cittadino now in second position. Bas Nys may have wanted to go to second position, but she could not make it. Christine Emerson now in fourth position. And there's Anna Gregg as Michael Krakander is falling back, just like Paul Winners over here and Joseph Ernesto. There, Aileen is out trying to get towards the front. She's right behind Kyle Thomas in the number 22 car. Oh, had to be careful though. Oh, is she going to make it four wide? Well, I'm not sure if that is going to happen. Well, this is really close racing. I will take you now on board with these guys. You will see how close the racing is over here. 22 does have a little bit of damage. Oh, makes the move down the inside. And we could best see it from over here. Stephen Kimball now also moving to the inside of Joseph Ernesto, who's falling like a rock. Sean Howell right behind him, also following. And Paul Winners is on the high side as well, getting passed by Harry Hills. There's Kevin Waters. Harry Hills and Kevin Waters are two good friends, if I'm correct. Jake Williams in the 08 car. We haven't been talking about him a lot today, but he's now starting to make progress. Dom Capps right behind the 0 car of Jared Stymest. Here comes Michael Krakander. He has fallen back because he has a little bit of damage. Blake Houshield also making it to his inside. Oops. And there you see Dirk Roodkloot. And Zachary Robinson. Actually, I believe that some people who got on... Well, we should take a look on pit road over here. I think that Judith... Oh, trouble. Oh, into the wall they go. Zachary Robinson involved. Nicole Tronovich, three cars over there of Sam Brady. Oh, more trouble. Oh, look out, guys. Slow down. Take it easy. Mind your spots. And, whoa, quite some carnage over here. Judith Piet, I wanted to say... Oh, he hit the pit wall. Ooh, Kyle Thomas hit the pit wall. And that must have hurt. I want to again say about Judith Piet. She came on pit road, but she made it out of it. That's pretty surprising. Well, Kyle Thomas is done for the day. Keith Batson is on pit road. And Hayden Klein got passed by John Cittadino, I believe. So John Cittadino is back in the lead again. At least he scored as the leader. But they're waiting on the pace car. And there the 43 comes flying by. I'm not sure what he's doing. I think he's lapped down. There he is, 27th position. Oh, he got lapped by John Cittadino. So quite some things are shaken up now. We'll take you to what happened. Bring us in our third caution of the day. So this is where it started to go wrong with Kyle Thomas and the 38 car of Sean Howell. They got into each other, I think, over here. Or at least Sean Howell. No, 22 just got loose and the 38 followed him. And hard into the wall there, Kyle Thomas goes. As he got hit by Sean Howell also. And 7 car. And then everybody behind her started getting into each other. There you see 3 car getting up off the ground a bit. So Kyle Thomas was involved and multiple people were spinning up front over here. And quite some big carnage there. Connor Breen went around. And Shane Pinter we should look at now. He got loose right in front of Sean Howell. And Sean Howe got into him there. The 89 car goes, or the 87 car goes. 89 car also got into it a little bit, but I'm not sure if she got damaged. And there you can just see them spinning. And now everybody starts stacking up as people were trying to get back to the line. Dirk Roogkloot, well, he was already under caution, so he needed to slow down, and he was holding up a few people. There's Sean Howell, Nicole Tronowicz, and then let's see, Kyle Thomas wants to get on pit road, but Judith Piette was there, and then he is a little bit slow, and he runs, boom, into the pit wall. Wow, it wasn't really hard hit, he just brushes it, but, well, he's out of the race now, I think. So let's take another look from the helicopter view, which should take a look now. Here we go. Excuse me. Full speed now, as like 8 people went into the wall over here. Hard hit for the 7 car as well. And there they're just spinning. 43 car, 3 car you see over there. Also 24 car, Nicole Tronowicz. And then Kyle Thomas tries to get by everybody, but, well, he decides, well, I have to get on pit road, have to get on pit road, have to get on pit road. Wait, the car is there. Oh, okay. Here we go, here we go. Oh, bang, done. For the day, Kyle Thomas is. Oops. Oh. So I will get you one final replay, which is on board with the 38 car of Sean Howell. And you will see, when you see this, you can see Scar spinning all around him. Here we go. Oops. There's somebody spinning in front of him. Jane Pin. Ooh, bang. 87 car. Ooh, oh, oh. Where'd he go? Ooh. Oh, wait, bang. Wait, wait, wait. Oh, Dirk Roogkloot. Let me get by here. There you go. And Sean Howell continues his way. As few people pitted and, well, few people tried to pit. So eventually, John Cittadino made the move on Hayden Klein just before the start-finish line. So he is scored as your leader, as we will go green flag racing right now. We are back again with John Cittadino in the lead. Second is Zachary Robinson. Okay, that's kind of weird scoring over here. Hayden Klein is in third. Fourth is Bastianis. Fifth is Christine Emerson. 16th, Anna Gregg. Seventh, Aline Suiten. Eighth, Harry Hills. Ninth, Joseph Nesto. And tenth is Jake Williams. And I'm so surprised. What the heck is Zachary Robinson doing over there in second position? He was a lap down, but now he suddenly is in second. So I guess he got lucky over there with just how things turn out to be. As we go green flag racing, I'm not sure if he is going to be up to speed. Of course, he does have some damage. Well, just got lucky, I think. But Hayden Klein will soon or later make a move on him. And I think that move will indeed come very soon. Ooh, here, Anna Gregg trying to make moves, go to the front. Oh, got into there. Hayden Klein and Zachary Robinson. And that is what I was waiting for. And now the 43 car is hung up on the outside. So he's trying to get back down low. Christine Emerson, she gets to his inside. No, I think he will be all right. Yes, indeed. Slides in third. Another lucky break for Zachary Robinson. Well, you do have to get some luck. And two teammates are still together over there. Joseph Nesto and Bastianis. They've been together for a long time. Aline Suiten, 9th, and 10th is Jared Stymest. As Paul Winners is making moves to the front again. Looking at the competition between the four guys. Paul Winners, Michael Krakander, Bertus Fred and Dirk Roogkloot. Well, Michael Krakander is, I think, oh, Nicole Tronowicz is moving again. Well, that's funny. Oh, there's Bertus Fred. And he's now right in front of Michael Krakander. So it seems, oh, and there's Dirk Roogkloot. But look at the damage on Nicole Tronowicz's car. Well, she has a lot of damage. There's Judith Piette and Kevin Waters with all the damage. And oh, more contact. Zachary Robinson and Christine Emerson. Anna Gregg moves up high, will allow the 5 card to get on her inside. Well, not yet. And now the 43 card is going to lose some more positions. Well, that's a way you have to pass over here. Just get it into somebody. Get him or break his momentum. And then you can move to the front. As teammates are looking to be working together a little bit over here. Bessonis and Joseph Onesto. Of course, Joseph Onesto has helped me a lot with everything in Dascar and everything I've done. We together are painting the cars for the Philips Cup Series Season 6. So I'm really glad that he's helping me out with that. Also, again, just have to say the TomTom International Touring Series, which is Joseph Onesto's series, is running. He has now 27 cars, I believe. He wants to get 42 cars. That will make it all better. So if you aren't signed up for it, go check it out. As Aileen Seid almost got somebody else into the wall. 5 car over there of Harry Hills. And now she's, well, man, she's making moves over here. Ooh, caution may be out, I think. I think caution is out over here. Indeed, caution is out. So somebody got into trouble. It's Michael Krakander. And maybe he got into Dirk Roogkloot and Kevin Waters. Not sure who was all involved. So, skimming through the field fairly quickly. Of course, we do not have a full field, 31 cars, but that's just because I only want to get 31 cars. Because the track only allows 31 cars. But it's still John Cittadino in the lead, as he has been leading most of the laps over here. Heine Klein has gone by him, but John Cittadino seems to be having the strongest car over here. But it's just a matter of getting the pole position and getting up front early, and passing here for the lead is fairly difficult. But of course, we're not sure what Heine Klein can do about him, and maybe 42 car of Christine Emerson can make something happen. And like right now in fourth position somehow. But we'll come to the lineup later for the green flag. First, we're going to take a look what happened to Michael Krakander, bringing us an hour, what is it, fourth or fifth caution of the day. And it was indeed a matter of Michael Krakander and Dirk Roogkloot getting together. Look at what happens over here. 92 car drives it in. No, actually, they did not get together. But they spun together. Ooh, there they got together. Hard hit for Dirk Roogkloot and Michael Krakander. And fun thing is, Michael Krakander got on pit road and he got out of it without any problems. So I'm not sure what these guys are doing then on pit road. There, Joshua Michaels and others also. Keith Batson most likely, but he got out of everything. All right, so just to show you one more replay. It's time to get on board now with... There you can see Sean Howell and also Jamie Emerson and Keith Batson are on pit road. Let's go on board over here with Dirk Roogkloot. Here we go. This has really not been Dirk Roogkloot's race, and also Michael Krakander's had a lot of bad luck. So John Cittadino is in the lead. Let's see if he can win this race, or maybe Heine Klein can do something about him. Christine Emerson, Anna Gregg, and Zachary Robinson also right behind him. Here we go. Green flag. We're back again with John Cittadino in the lead. Second is Heine Klein, third is Christine Emerson. Fourth is Anna Gregg. By the way, just want to say that this car of Christine Emerson is one of my favorites. It's really great looking. Fifth is Zachary Robinson after his luck. Harry Hills is in sixth position. Seventh is Aileen Seid. Eighth, Bessonis. Ninth, Joseph Onesto. Man, they have been together all the race long. Jared Stymus is in tenth. So let's show you your standings over here, as few people are a lot of laps down. And I think that actually, not even sure if anybody has retired. Just a lot of people laps down. Of the four people, I think Paul Winners is running best indeed in 11th position. And then it is Bertus Fred in 20th position. But we're green flag racing. John Cittadino, Heine Klein. We got 9 laps to go or something. well, will be 8 laps now, I think, if I'm correctly. And John Seidman, Hayden Klein is right on the rear bumper of John Cittadino. I think he may have something before this race is over. Looking to get something happen over here. Hayden Klein, he has won a couple of races. John Cittadino as well. Ooh, contact over here. Oh, look out. Zachary Robinson and Harry Hills got together. And that has moved Zachary Robinson to the high side of the racetrack. He's being followed there by Aline Suit and now Joseph Anesta. Ooh, the two TND cars are separated now. Jared Steim is going underneath a couple of people over there. Aline Suit tries to slide in there in line on the low side. Oh, contact. More contact. Well, we see a lot of contact over here, but they save it most of the times. Sometimes they don't. John Cittadino on pit road, Joshua Michaels. And we have a hole now from 5th back to 6th position over here. Bastianese. Ooh, Bastianese, you have to look out. It's very easy to get loose over here. Very easy. So have to be careful when making moves and just with your steering wheel. One wrong move and you're in the wall. And we've seen that happen quite some times today. As my dog is still laying beside me. Really a lazy thing over there. Side by side now, Joseph Nesta losing more and more positions. We go 3 wide over here. And that can work at this racetrack. And we've seen it happen over here. Inge Lambeliana. And Dom Capps was there as well as James Pinter. Ooh. Close racing, and I think they want to make it 3 wide once again. Oh, just notice we're almost in the last lap, as there Michael Krakander is. But I want to get to John Cittadino, who gets the white flag. Man, these laps are going fast. John Cittadino has to get around one more time. Coming into turn number 3 and turn number 4, he is going to be the first one to win a race in the Dascar Shell Dirt Ringer Series. Congratulations to John Cittadino on winning this race. He's the first one to have won a race over here. As we go to our official standings, you can see just one person has retired, which is Kyle Thomas, but Joshua Mikes, Keith Batch, Jamie Emerson, Sean Howell, and also Nicole Trnovic, possibly, they have been on pit road for quite some time, and Jamie Emerson almost for the entire race. So, well, you could pretty much see them as retired, but just they won't retire. Don't actually know why, but oh well. John Cittadino won this race. Hayden Klein in second position. Christine Emerson, solid job for the rookie. Well, not for the rookie. In third position. Anna Gregg. Harry Hill's best finishing rookie, though, in NASCAR. In fifth position. Then we got Aline Suiten, Bastianese. Zachary Robinson, I have no clue how he did that. He was a lap down, but he got very lucky and he finished in 8th position. Pool winners, the best of the 4 people who are holding a competition. Let's see, Bert Schvret in 18th, Dirk Rogelow 23rd, and Michael Krakander 25th. So big lead there for pool winners. And Blake Houshield finishing in 10th position. So we had a good race over here at Fonda Speedway. Not sure when I'm going to do the next race. Probably coming weekend. Of course, 3 more days for me to go. And then I have my summer holiday. Really looking forward to it. Going to do a lot of racing. A lot of NASCAR racing 2003. And possibly other things as well. Next time we will go to Orange County Fair State Speedway or something. And I'm not really sure about the names. I'm not even sure if this is called Fonda Speedway. Oh, it's called Fonda Speedway. That's great. We will go there for the Budweiser 300. Just for you guys to know, I made the races fairly short. Well, of course, this is already a long race, but I've done a lot of crap talk in the beginning. So I'm also now again. But I made the race like Fonda is 280 miles, just like Canandaigua. And then we got three races, which are 300 miles. Orange County, Minnesota, and indeed Syracuse. I should say Syracuse, not Syracuse. But of course, Weed Sports was on the schedule, but I removed that because we had trouble with last five cars lining up on the start. They were all the way in the back, and after just a few laps, they all pitted and retired. So not sure how that's going to happen. So last race will be at Syracuse. And of course, Syracuse, if you have seen the Phillips Cup Series race, it's a great racetrack. Really great racetrack. 300 miles, and that's going to be the longest race. So, well, I'm going to round things up over here. Congratulations to John Cittadino winning the race. And, of course, there are only six races, so winning is really big over here. I want to thank you for watching, and I will see you next time at Orange County Fair State Speedway or something for the Budweiser 300. Also, keep an eye on the Starbucks Super Speedway Series sign-ups for Season 3, which will be up this week. Not sure when I will start the series, but oh well, I will figure that out. Still have to paint a couple of cars. So ladies and gentlemen, I will see you next time. Thank you for watching. First race ever on dirt, of Dirt Series. Man, we're going to do another Dirt Series after that with the late model. Probably same race, just also same name and same racetracks. But, well, first rounding off this season. First, as we have just started it. Ladies and gentlemen, I'll see you next time. 2013 NASCAR Shell Dirt Ringer Series.